this up. Good day, folks. I had to check it out, my man, Mick Jenkins. Cop his album, man, called Waves, Trees of Life, and another album he got called Water. The man is hot. You think Kendrick Lamar is on? Man, check out Mick Jenkins. He's killing the game, man. He's killing the conscious movement rap. Just check it out. But this is about zoology and typology meets. And this is going to make some of you sad. This is going to make some of you happy. And this is going to make some of you folks just going to fade out, going to want to hate me. Because it's going to expose the truth. And if anybody loved the Most High and loved themselves, they're going to love the truth. Because the truth is the new king. Truth is the new savior. Truth is the new leader. And they say the Most High, the creator, Yah Allah. Yah meaning the expression, and Allah meaning God. Not that generic version of the moon and all that other perverted stuff. Speaking of perversion, have you ever thought, or if it hasn't dawned on you, how perverted your fellow man is, or your fellow sister, or your brother is, say they're conscious, and this, and we represent that. But for some reason, we don't mind saying, what's up, dog? We're going to start with the men first, the word dog. And this is where we go, this is where zoology comes in at. When I see a dog, and I breed dogs, and I've shared some pictures with dogs, they got four legs, fangs, fur, and they walk on all fours. Now, when you call another human being, that's my dog, what are you saying to yourself? Think about that. When you see a man, you say, man, that's my dog. What do you see? Literally. Like, this is my smartphone. It's an actual phone. I don't know if it's smart, but it has some stuff in there that has some intelligence in it. I see it. It's in my hand. And I use it, and it does what I request of it. But when I just go to my fellow brother who I say I love, and more power, and black power, and we got the bill. How can you deal with a dog? I just want to know that. You scholars and imams and pastors and young up-and-coming leaders and things like that. How is it that we can hang around people who don't know what they're talking about? Literally, this is about the typology part. The typology in the mind saying, what's up, dog? And so it overtypes or it overruns the real program of nature. Because when I see a man or I see my brother, he's not a dog. Same thing with this thing called black man or black people. My phone is black. And it's intelligent phone, and it is a cell phone. So once again, the facts, the truth, right now, what you're looking at, is a black cell phone, smartphone. That's what it is. Now, if I go to you, my brother, I say you my brother, and I say I love me, and I say I love the truth. If I say you're my dog, or you my nigga, or you my my black family, am I not a liar? Am I not saying something that I'm really not looking at? Think about that. This is a watch. And you tell somebody, I'm going to go watch. What would be the first thing to come to your mind? You're going to go watch, literally, watch something. So the real name for this would be called a timepiece. Because what it do, it keeps time. It keeps your schedule. It keeps all your things. You see where zoologic meets typology? Back to the nigga thing in the zoology. So now that we're so happy calling each other blacks and niggas, which there is, you can't see it. Even if you go into the hottest part of Africa, these people are not black. So there goes that out the water. There is no black Africans or black people. Let's go to another example. There is blue ink on white paper. And this is white paper. From a zoologic and typology. If you go to somebody and say, that's a white man, do he look like this? Or are you lying to yourself? Or have you been programmed to accept typologies that kills the truth that is in your soul? And to kill the energy that is in your mind? You might as well do dope. Really. I mean, when you really think about it, that's no different than shooting dope. Because in the mind, it's going to take you to shoot dope. So if your mind is poison and you're not even on dope, weed, alcohol, or nothing, and you're still calling people my nigga, black people, white people, you're still on drugs. You're still high up. In fact, you're worse than the addict. Why? Because you're addicted to lying to yourself and then trying to get other people to conform to that and then give them a book. And say, see, it's in the book. Black is this. But when you look at it, and you read the book, like, well, hold up. What I'm seeing is not even in the book. Typology. This is the one that really kills our people, and it kills humanity. It's this word called bitch. Remember, we're talking about dogs, right? Now, a bitch has four legs, fangs, fur, tail, pointy ears, floppy ears. She comes spotted. She has at least four pups, not children. What else? And she does come in heat. She does let many of the dogs hump on her because that's her nature. That's just what happens in the dog and bitch world. Follow me on this. This is heavy. So now we get Amber Rose, who messed with this guy who's from my city. I'm not gonna say his name because I'm not into promoting this bullshit. She wrote a book called How to Be a Bad Bitch. Now, women who say they stand for all women, women who say they stand for the respect of women, women who say they want the respect of men and the respect of their enemies and the respect of the community, they want the respect of the universe. How do you let other women promote zoology and typology on your soul and on your essence, on your creativity, on your queenship? How do you, so you talk about men hating women and men doing women bad, but you your own self support the injustice of telling each other, I am a bad bitch. Now check out what bad bitches do. They get breast implants. They get booty implants. They make up their whole face with
fuck.
Now check this out. When you look at the bitch's toolbox, it's made of all animal-based products, from the makeup, the hair, the silicone booty, the lipstick, the clothing, everything. Especially a black bitch. Especially a nigga black bitch. Because she got rainbows in her hair. Zoologic. Zoology meets typology. You see that type of ology? You see that type of zoology? And it's become acceptable amongst dogs and bitches. Not amongst men and women, but dogs and bitches. So what's the difference between men and women and males and females? Here's the difference. Males and females are dogs and bitches. Men and women are overrulers of dogs and bitches. See, a man and a woman is not the same species as male and female. Thus, they have the same types of gender when it comes to procreation. See, this is only where gender makes it any point. That's why it says, when you have sex with a man, woman, and when you have sex with a woman, man, it is a spiritual marriage. Why? Because you are conscious, you are aware of your male and female anatomy. And when the male and the female get together like ones and zeros in a battery code or computer, becomes new life, becomes new world, becomes new birth, becomes new existence, becomes new opportunities, becomes new ways to advance on the planet and in the universe and the celestial wisdom. Males and females don't get that. They're pre-programmed. They're already predestined. Y'all feel that? So let's get back to this bitch. This bad bitch syndrome. This bad bitch typology. This bad bitch zoologic. And then we got a lot of people who call themselves bitch. As I watch Atlanta Housewives, and I'm looking at all these females. Not women. These are not women. These are females that call themselves bitches. Now, when you look at the history of our people, and you say, hold up, T.I., P. Diddy, all these basketball wives and all you football players and all you got money and da-da-da-da, when you didn't have nothing, what were you? You said you wanted to be respected as a man and a woman. But as soon as you get that contract of the devil, soon as you get that contract of the pale skin and the enemy, you flipped your own nature and said, I'm that nigga, bitch. And you get that song, I'm that baddest bitch by Trina, you know what I mean? And then you started promoting Satan's gender war, male and female. See, man and woman is not a gender. Let's get that right. Man and woman is not a gender. Male and female is a gender. Man and woman is the overlord, for lack of a better term, is the overseer, the custodian of the male and female gender of all species. Let me repeat that for you in case you didn't get it. The man and the woman are the custodians of the male and female species on the planet. Whether it's an insect, water, fire, elements, whatever the case may be, man has the power and the authority over this gender thing. But you'd rather be a bad bitch or that nigga or that dog. Typology meets zoologic and zoology. How long do you think we're supposed to accept this? How long do you think the universe is going to accept this? How long do you think the cosmos is going to accept this before you get destroyed? And this is not about color of skin. This is about zoology and typology. So back to this bitch thing. You got all this funny colored hair. You got all these women with all this taking pictures with their booties sticking out. What the what is that? So-called black woman? And you so-called black man? What is this? Did you come getting on Facebook and all this stuff, taking your clothes off? What is that? You keep asking for justice, but your own self is being unjust to yourself. As an individual, as a family, as a community, as a unity, as a nation. And then you get on TV and you say, I'm a baddest bitch. I'm that bitch. Look at my brand. Look at my clothing line. Look at my Versace. Look at, but then when you look at the clothing that you're promoting, it's the same people that you say you hate is sponsoring and making your shit. Zoology. Who was your handler? Who is the bitch's handler? Who is the dog's handler? But Satan himself. Because they don't know that they're a man or a woman. And don't know how to be and have no desire to be. Why? Because you get paid for it. How I can talk this shit? Because I used to be guilty. See, and you can't talk if you ever conquered this shit. This is for anybody and anybody anywhere. Be quiet if you're still doing it. Be quiet if you haven't conquered it. Be quiet if you can't tell nobody how to get out of it. So we're going to tell you how to get out of it. But we have to understand the problem first. Let's address the problem. I like certain rap songs and stuff myself. I don't like the songs. I like the beats, especially Zaytoven. He has some wonderful sounds and stuff like that. But the people who got on the sounds, I don't care for. Like James, the new Young Thug with James or something like they changed the name to James. Even though I don't like the dude's style, that's his problem, that's between him and the Most High. But the beats is hot. So I understand that. But when we hear the vibration of lies, we have to address it. Like when we hear I'm that nigga, I'm that bitch, and all these things, then we draw accustomed to it. This is where the typology comes in, because now we're living a type of lifestyle in our head that is not real. Don't take my word for it. Go out and try it. I'm getting off a little track here. Excuse me. Dear Heavenly Father, forgive me for not praying for us. I ask for permission to speak to your children. I ask that you'll give us the wisdom and the knowledge to accept these things and to work these things out. And we ask that we would teach one and reach one and begin to lift each other up and not tear each other down according to your will. For your will is the best will. By the power of the Holy Spirit, I come. To the prophets before me and after me, we say thank you. Selah. Sisters, not bitches, not females. We're talking about sisters, our women. Please, if you want the respect in the so-called goddess level that you want, you have to turn your back on the fight against the male and female thing. You have to turn your back on how this man treated you back in the day. You have to turn your back on what the males did to you. Turn towards your so-called fellow females and tell them first that we ain't not standing for this bitch thing no more. With this icon where the bitch is supposed to be. Because a bitch is a female, not a woman. And so when I see a bitch and a woman in the same room and they're communicating and they get together and make a strong fist, and then start to punch a real man, you have to ask yourself, what type of zoology is this? What is this? Same thing for the men. When you got a man and you got dogs trying to build a civilization, what do you think you have? Really, what do you think you're gonna get out of having males and men try to build something positive? Where do you think you get sex or gender and men trying to build? Where do you think you get sex, female, and women trying to build? And these are two different houses. To the left, bang. You get the right, bang. And every time we beating on the doors of life, bang, bang, boom, hitting uppercuts, wondering why we ain't did no damage. Think about it. my way. I gotta sip on some caramel poison called Pepsi or some crap. But yeah, I need to give me some more wine and peaches, huh? Good for the rest of my breakfast, normally. But think about it. For you people, it was in scripture. Didn't the Most High say you can't mix iron and clay? Isn't that the male, the clay, and the man, the iron? Isn't the woman, the female, the water, and the woman, the oil, that lubricates the machine of life? How do you... go back to typology. See, typology is where you take the true word or the true meaning of something and you flip it to mean something different and then make it glorious. What do you call that? A liar, a cheat, a thief, a no-do-gooder, wicked, lost, confused, outsane, crazy, diabolical, and the list goes on. Think about it. Don't take my word for it. You got brains just like I do. Think about it. How does a man and a male build anything positive? Can a man and a plant have a child? A male plant or a female plant? No. Where do you think people having sex with animals come from? Think about it. Why would a woman have sex with an animal? Why would a man have sex with an animal? I mean, hell, it's a female. It got a womb. And y'all, and everybody, so-called black people, is already promoting the womb the yoni. How many things on this planet have a yoni? You think the female woman has it, only one that has a yoni? All types of plants and animals and insects have yonis. So while you worshiping this yoni, you bad bitch, you're unnatural, you're sick, you're diseased, and really you're not good for nothing except for being marketed. That's why they put you on TV. Yeah. Same thing with the so-called black man. You think because you have a gender male and it's called a phallus or a penis, and because you can go stick it in any hole, that thing that makes you a man. Actually, it just makes you more of a beast. Really, it makes you more of a beast because there are male insects or male dogs or male animals, fish, and all that, and they have a penis too. So all this penis pride and punani pride is all zoology and typology. It is a deception, it is a sickness, it is a disease. And what is so sad about this is that people say they're conscious, say they want to go back to Africa, they say they want to all this, but they don't even understand that they're defective. The mind state is defective. The heart's defective. The mind's defective. The soul, the spirit is defective. And you sit around here parading like it's beautiful. As gay Desmond Tutu, who messes with the Dalai Lama. Mandela, homosexual. Why, think about it. Why is it that homosexuality becomes so important in the churches and in our civilization? If this is not correct between zoology and typology. Here's a prime example of typology. All these years, you so-called black males and black females, dogs and bitches, niggas and niggets, been fighting for justice, been fighting for equal rights. And then all of a sudden, in less than 10 years, less than 5 years, the homosexual male and the homosexual female superseded you, so-called black man or black woman. They superseded you in law, commerce, building cities, organizations, schools, hospitals, cars, clothing, fashion, TV, technology, science, everything. They superseded you less than 5 years. Tell me if I'm wrong. If black is so beautiful, if being a black woman and black man and all this black, and bitch, nigga, dog, if that was so beautiful and that shit worked so wonderful, how come 5 years the gender had overran the God particle in the man and the woman who is natural to the universe? Tell me that. Ask your leaders. Ask anybody who's supposed to be conscious. Young Pharaoh, answer that too. Because I see everybody jock ride because you get all this philosophy stuff, man. Answer that. For the 56 bloods and the science and all these chemicals because we're the carbon and because from the pyramids we took this... Man, shut the fuck up. But that ain't got nothing to do with nothing right now. The unnatural is superseding us. Think about that. And y'all ain't mad. You ain't upset. That the very... I'm pissed. I'm sweating like a dog. The very unnatural of the universe, the very unnatural of the planet, the very unnatural of God, the very unnatural of our ancestors, the very unnatural of everything that exists, superseded you in 5 years and everything in 5 years. The homosexual movement has prospered. Oh my gosh. And y'all haven't figured out this shit. You haven't figured out this shit. And you so-called black women with all this fucking makeup and all this beauty shit, and you so-called black men, oh well, I got this thing and I got that and look at my temple and we got this and... And ain't shit moved. And you know, you'll say, some people say, well, Jose, you sitting here behind the screen, what the fuck is you doing? I'm putting in that, I already put in that work. I already hit the streets, I already hit the schools, I already hit the colleges. We already been pushing this all for the past 15, 20 years. But nobody wanted to gravitate to it. You know why? Because everybody wanted to be black and wanted to be black dogs and bitches. Everybody wanted to be male and female. Everybody wanted to fight over gender. So I sat back and said, you know what? We're just going to ride the truth. We put in that work. We research every day, all day. We practice what we preach. Folks who know me, they tell you, we ain't budging on this. We ain't moving on this. You can kill me all you want to. I already got the tea. I already got the damages. I already got the damages of putting this in here. I got the scars already putting this work in. But this, that comes with the job. That ain't nothing to be put at a pat on the back and all that. That comes with the job. That comes with being a trailblazer. That comes with going first so when somebody else come behind you, don't have to do it so hard, but perfect it. I'm telling you this day, as the Most High lives, if you don't understand what it means to be a man and a woman and not focus on your gender, male and female, you will lose, you will die, you will go to prison, they will make laws, and if you curse one of them LGBT homosexual folks, you're going to prison and they're going to hang your ass. You know why? Because they did something that your coward asses wouldn't do. Accept what they are. Became something from what they knew what they are. And they accepted the truth what they rejected. They rejected the Most High. They rejected nature. And they telling you, look, we reject it. But you so-called black people and black folks, y'all don't want to admit I reject the Most High. You don't want to admit I reject the man in me. You don't want to admit I reject the woman in me. You don't want to admit I reject the culture. You don't want to admit that I sold out for a contract. And then be honest. Miss Conway calling yesterday. Look, I sold my life for a crappy record deal. He told you. Jay-Z, he told you. Beyonce, they told you. All the artists, a lot of them pretty much told you, we sold out. I don't know why you keep trying to use me and put me on a pedestal, nigga. I sold out. Look at my wrist. I'm not thinking about you. I'm riding my muscles. Look at Polite even told you. Brother Polite, see my tongue, fella. Polite even told you, look, I'm doing me. I never had the shit of the devil. I'm enjoying the devil right now. I'll get back to the holy stuff later. Little did he know, when he decided to take the devil's toys, he can't come back. Not because I said so, but the universe said it. And he'll be just like Eddie Law. He'll get sick with AIDS or having all the sex from women because somebody's going to poison one of his wives, and that's how they get into you. And to you men, know this. If your woman is weak, the devil and your enemies is going to get you through your woman. This is how every kingdom fails. This is how every king falls. This is how every movement falls. This is how we fall. We let the enemy attack our women, and then our women bring that poison to us. That's why I believe in the Genesis in the Bible, because it says Satan came to the woman and that infected Adam, or Atom, A-T-O-M. That affected the man. We are these brothers. Stand up for your God particle and scrutinize the words of the woman. Go over what she's saying. Go over her wisdom. Investigate her wisdom. Just don't take it because, oh, that's a woman. Oh, that's because that's my mother. Oh, that's because she bore my children. Oh, because, oh, that's the mother goddess. Get the fuck out of here, man. You try to kill all of us with that weak shit? And you women, stop letting these bitches, this zoologic, infiltrate and type over your beautiful, your goddess particle. Y'all got the power, and it seems like you just traded in for makeup and for attention and emotion. What is it about this emotional shit that keep destroying us? And then when you ain't emotional no more, oh man, I was just, you know, smoke another sack. You know, it's cool. And go back to sleep. It don't work like that, man. It don't work like that. It don't work like that. Typology meets zoology. Zoology meets typology. Where'd that song go? I ain't got no type. I get it.